verge of a clean sweep, a 3-0 start to this year's NBA Finals. We'll see if they can pull it off. Good evening, everyone. This is Kevin Hartman alongside Clint Cooley and Steve Kerr. We'll see the Golden State Warriors facing Cleveland. Now a chance to check out on our starting lineups. Someone will be keeping an eye on, of course, LeBron James.
But because of his passing ability, Kevin, if you're going to play with him, your only job is to get open on the floor because he will get you the ball, and he'll give it to you in rhythm so that you can get a good shot.
And, Steve, very few players have this finishing ability. We see him get a lot of and-ones because even if he draws hard contact, he is able to play through that and typically score.
We'll take a look at the Cavaliers. They're trailing 3-0. They're hoping for a miracle. They're going to lay it all on the line tonight as they look for their first win of this series.
Well, obviously, guys, they've got an uphill battle. Nobody has ever come back from a 3-0 series deficit. But, you know, you just try to win one game, and you never know what happens. Injury-wise, momentum-wise, a crazy break here or there. Just win this one and give yourself a chance.
Well, their fans certainly haven't given up, Steve. I mean, they're steeled behind this team 100%. And 3-0 comebacks have happened in hockey and baseball. Maybe it's time for it to happen in basketball.
And here is Irving. Love with the screen for Irving. Back to Love. J.R. Smith on the wing. It's rebounded by Pachulia.
Tough D on the inside. Put up a roadblock, a construction barrel right there. That's what he brings defensively.
Here's Durant. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Durant's got his first 2 points.
His presence is very comforting for this team. He's kind of a fallback option for them anytime they need it.
Another shot, and he lays it up and in.
Well, something special about him, guys, is just how good he is at winning the so-called second shot game, going hard to the offensive glass, salvaging points with his putbacks.
And he is also a tireless worker under the glass, Steve. More than a few guys have been on the receiving end of one of his elbows when a rebound is up for grabs. He uses his body very well.
You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days is that little finger roll.
LeBron James on the wing, defended by Durant. LeBron dishes to Irving. Drops in the tray. Irving's got himself on the board with 3-0.
And you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Here's Green. We've got 33 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Knocks it loose. And now Irving pushing it up. Brown back to step in.
Completely rattled an opponent's rip.
Yeah, and it's such terrific on-the-ball defense to trigger the transition opportunity.
And it wasn't just the tough D, it was the exclamation point they put on the fast break with the slam.
And now the fast break, Irving with the ball, and the dunk by Love.
Heads up play on both ends there. A transition basketball, the steal and the quick push.
Steve, that's how it should be played. I mean, rapid-fire basketball.
Outside Curry. And he can't stop the run as he misses. Here's Irving. No good on that last second attempt here. And that does it for the first quarter. Cavaliers lead by 4. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Quicken Loans Arena. And welcome back to our presentation of the NBA Finals as we get going again. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Cavaliers?
You know what, guys? It looks to me like they're really in sync here, all on the same page. They've already got a bunch of assists.
And they're also showing some muscle here in the first half, finding a lot of points in the paint area.
Here's Iguodala. So on the floor for Golden State to begin the second quarter. They've got Iguodala. Jones is out there with Barnes. And there's Livingston. And it's McGee in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And it's good. Iguodala's got the opening field goal of the second quarter for the Warriors.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Back to Smith. Pass to LeBron. LeBron gets the screen from Thompson. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. LeBron's got three assists in the game. Warriors trail by four. Here is Livingston. And Tristan Thompson gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, you know, these calls can be some of the toughest in the game for the officials.
It all happened so fast, but I really think that was the right call. The defender was not really set in that situation.
McGee, the pass to Iguodala. Kicks it to Jones. Back to Iguodala. Shot clock at six. Gets it to go. Barnes has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Here in the second quarter with a little over a minute gone. Love with the screen for Irving. Loses his run off the screen and lays it up and in.
Seems to me that anytime the game is on the line, he's perfectly willing to be the hero or the goal for that matter. And that's what it takes to be clutch in big situations. You can't be afraid to fail.
There's one other thing about him. It's how easy he makes it look to change his shot in midair. And usually with defenders all around him. Because of that, it's really hard to block one of his shots.
It's LeBron with the drive. And there's another one for the Cavaliers.
The mid-range jumper becomes a pretty high percentage shot for him when he has that kind of space.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Livingston, that's good.
I love the finger roll up and over the defense.
For Cleveland, they've gone a nice 3-of-3 to start the second. Irving with it. He's got seven. Five to shoot. Back to Love. All alone. It's a tie game here in Cleveland. And we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
From this crucial Game 4 of the NBA Finals, we dig into the storylines for what went down in the first half. The Cavaliers putting up one heck of a fight. It's close, and you know they'll be coming out just as hungry as they look to avoid an NBA Finals sweep. Kyrie Irving certainly contributing with his play. His field goal percentage through the roof recently, and he is on fire again tonight. But you know, the Warriors also came to play. They've gotten a tremendous boost from their reserves, going to them early in the game for production. Andre Iguodala playing well in the first half, and they love the output they've gotten from Klay Thompson, too. And now, we'll send you back out to Quicken Loans Arena. See you next time.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Welcome back to Game 4 as we get ready to start things up again. Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
Yeah, in a game this important, we knew his contributions were going to be critical for this team. And I thought he really delivered in the first half.
And here in the second, the stakes are raised even higher, so he's going to have to continue to give them someone to lean on here.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. On the court for Cleveland, they've got LeBron James. J.R. Smith out there with Kyrie Irving. Then there's Tristan Thompson. And it's Love in at the power forward. LeBron outside. Stolen by Thompson. And here we go with Thompson running in off the court. Smith with the ball.
And it turns out it's going to be a foul. He was hoping for a clean hop, but the officials thought otherwise. So we'll see some free throws here.
And of all the things about him that you like offensively, it's his composure that jumps out at me. The way he never gets rattled. The defense can get in him. He doesn't care. He just continues to do his thing.
And something else you notice about him offensively is what a dangerous catch-and-shoot player he is. He's got a quick trick.
And so Thompson nails both of them.
He's a dead-eye at the line, fellas. Just call him automatic. He doesn't miss many of those.
Durant against McGuire. Shot is off. The Warriors go the other way with it. Excited about the win on Thursday.
And I think Kevin really showed how important it is to have a strong bench performance. You go out on the road, you can't rely on your starters night in and night out. The reserves have to contribute and help them out.
I think we definitely saw that, Steve, throughout the game. They were really tied together as a team. Didn't make any difference who was out on the floor. You'll take every road game win you can, and they're happy with that. A clear look at the hoop. He doesn't miss many of those.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones a long time without a
pass. That's what we came to see. Aggressive, assertive basketball.
He just threw that one down with as much strength as he could muster.
He got that one. An angry dunk.
40 seconds left in the third quarter. Warriors leading by three. And Thompson kicks to Green. And again, no good by Golden State. Cavaliers have gone 1-3 since starting the second half. LeBron dishes to Irving. The Warriors pull it in.
Some rugged defense there against one of the stronger finishers in the game.
Curry against Irving. Curry passes it to Durant. Right side, Durant. Inside, Pachulia. That's good. And a nice assist from Durant. And we've reached the end of the third. The Warriors on top. They lead by five. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Warriors.
These long-range shots look like layups out there, guys.
I've been impressed with how well they've done so far tonight, too.
And Golden State, I don't know who they got. Draymond Green is out there. Pachulia. And it's Klay Thompson. And it's Durant. And it's Curry in at the one spot. And it's Kevin Love with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And Thompson gets the kill. Stolen by Thompson.
And that passing lane wasn't open for long. He closed the guy in a heartbeat to get that steal. Unstoppable offense from both teams. I love the pace this game has been played at.
So does everybody else in the building. This has been a fun one.
He's definitely the guy they want at the line in this situation. He loves these kinds of moments.
Thompson, this is the proof. We've got 1:28 left in the fourth quarter. It's Durant on the left.
Fancy with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
Man, I like that. I mean, some coaches might want to see just a sure-handed lay-in, but I say put as much as you can on the finish and get your teammates going.
Here's Irving following the score by Golden State. He's back up, and Durant sends it back. Golden State's gotten a success rate of just over 50% from three-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. Curry's shot is good.
Excellent vision by Durant out there. What a nice pass.
The Cavaliers trail by 4. Irving kicks to Smith. Nails it! And he is
brought them to within 2 points.
Oh, what a clutch shot. That could be the difference maker.
Big, big moment in this game.
Down low. Petrunia, come up. Absolutely critical chance right here.
Now they need this one to go their way, Kelly.
Thompson passes to Durant. Outside court. Here's Petrunia. Can't play to go. And it's the Cavaliers taking it the other way. It's a 4 second differential between the shot clock and game clock. The pass to LeBron. LeBron with the screen on Durant. Here's LeBron.
It's in!
He has tied up this game. Oh, what a shot.
Boy, they're having major trouble dealing with LeBron.
Curry attacking. Missed.
Well, it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense if he missed it.
Here's LeBron. Oh, it's no good. And we're headed to overtime. Regulation is ended, and we're heading to overtime. And we'll be back with you right after this. Well, if you're just joining us, the intensity has really heated up in this one. As we watch this one go now to overtime. So Golden State will get the first possession. So the overtime period is now ticking away. Should be fine. Courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineup for us now in overtime. Setting the floor for the Warriors. Durant is out there with Draymond Green. Then there's Petrunia. And there's Klay Thompson. And it's Curry in at the point guard. Irving kicks to Smith. Smith off a back from Thompson. Back to Irving.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
Warriors shooting it very well tonight, around 57%. Here's Curry with the three.
Drills it from long range.
That one just took the air right out of the crowd.
Yeah, he simply said, sit down and keep quiet with that.
Yeah, that's right. Nothing coming out of these fans now.
James. And he's knocked off course by the knee. The foul call. He'll shoot free throws. He hits the first one, and that lowers the gap to one. He's perfect from the line this time.
Incredible composure at the line to tie it up and give them a chance to get it to overtime.
To the inside.
Big bucket. We've got to play for a stop here with the 2-point lead. No open three.
And the Cavaliers call time here. They trail by two. We've got 22 seconds left in the first overtime. Guys, your thoughts?
Well, what do you think, Doug? Do you go for the two or the three here?
I don't think you choose one or the other ahead of time. I think you try to take what's available. You get the best shot as quickly as you can.
The three, Love misses the trail. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Smart foul there. You got to try to extend the game.
Yeah, it's still close, but they're fighting that clock as much as the score right now.
And now we've got the intentional foul. Good on the first, and that makes it a 3-point lead. And so both free throws are good, and it's a 4-point ball game.
No mistakes there. I think you can close the book on this one, guys. It's done.
That one wide left. And now they foul and stop the clock.
Come on, you're gonna miss it.
He drops the first one, and that puts them up by five. Second one is good, hitting both at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game. Overtime still getting started here, just about a minute in. Here's LeBron. Oh, good.
The celebration begins on the hardwood. Really a mixture of emotion. And you got to believe it's one that can hardly be described accurately.
Well said, Clark. This is exactly the moment they wanted. And quite a contrast indeed of emotions.
Well, as much as you'd like to clinch it in front of your home fans, guys, there's something really special about doing it on the road and just seeing the shocked faces of the home crowd and the silence that envelops the arena. It is quite an accomplishment to do so in the face of such adversity.
And now for the presentation of the Larry O'Brien Trophy and the Bill Russell Finals MVP Award. Let's go down to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
Thank you to these extraordinary NBA teams. We're the Eastern and Western Conference champions. Only one team can win the Larry O'Brien Trophy and the title of NBA champion. So congratulations to the fans, the coaching staff, and a wonderfully talented team. Your 2014 NBA champions, the Golden State Warriors.
Well, they did it. And as they celebrate, you can just see the relief, the uninhibited joy, I mean, the exhilaration that comes with winning it all.
And Clark, these home fans, a celebration they can only witness in frustration and disappointment, Steve. It is some kind of feeling, certainly.
Yeah, it is. For these fans, I mean, to come so close, almost getting there with their team, now all of a sudden to have to watch the opponent celebrate on their floor, a bitter pill to swallow for sure.
And now our attention will turn to the floor and NBA Commissioner Adam Silver for the presentation of the Bill Russell NBA Finals MVP Award.
A tremendously talented player and deserving the award named for Bill Russell, the ultimate champion. Congratulations to the winner of the Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player Award.
Mark, I can speak for myself, but hasn't this been a tremendous playoffs?
It really has been, Kevin. I mean, you never know when you start the postseason what you're in store for, how things will turn up. But we now all know what the end result was.
Steve, I know you've enjoyed every second of this series.
Yeah, it's been phenomenal to watch, Kevin. And what impresses me the most is, you know, the NBA playoffs are such a grind. To win it all, to go through so much adversity, the roller coaster ride of emotions. And now all of a sudden this team can just relax and let out everything and enjoy the night.
And we have enjoyed our time with you folks all season long. For Doris Burke, Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying so long. Have a wonderful summer.